minus 2. Solving question like this is good, right? Rather than giving you sheets and save papers.
Yeah, they're both C. Yeah, it's so
root GM
is
C. Both is C. First one is P, second
one is P. It's
root GM by
C.
Height
R. Height R. Height R.
Both C.
Yeah.
All of you getting C?
Yeah.
See, you have to be very honest with yourself. If you're not getting it, you have to say that I'm not getting it. Otherwise, time will just go. All of you got it? This means yes or no?
Yes.
And this?
Yes.
So this also means yes, this also means yes. Strange, or it matters with what frequency you are.
So that's called the Indian head bob. It was only Indians living.
Because Indians, they hate to say no for anything. So they'll be like, from their inside, no is coming out. So it'll be like, yes. Anyway, you're American citizen, right? Bush. Kinetic energy needed to project a body of mass m from the Earth's surface to infinity.
It's
just escape velocity, kinetic energy under root 2gre. So half m into
2gre.
So mgre. Okay. Then this one, particle at rest, distance r above the Earth's surface, the minimum speed. It is again the escape velocity only. But here, see, in this chapter, you keep on using this formula again and again. K, U1 is, U2 is 0, stop talking, K2 is 0. Why K2 is 0? Because you're trying to find the minimum initial velocity. This is, stop talking. This is, GMM by 2R. So earlier it was just R when it was thrown from the surface of the Earth, because distance from the center was R. Now distance from the center is 2R. So that is why U1 is this. Okay. So root GM by R. Earlier it was root GM by 2R. No, 2GM by R. Root 2GM by R. The last objective question, after that subjective will start.
No, sorry.
A, answer is A? No.
C.
You know it's an approximation.
A is not correct.
Is it C? Then it's probably C.
So A is out. You just have three options to choose. So chance that you'll get it right is 1 by 3 now. Done? Even C is wrong.
Then it's
then?
Why is it wrong?
B. Even B is wrong. Answer is D.
Why?
D for talking.
So why?
How?
What is asked? Relative velocity is asked. Kinetic energy depends on absolute velocity. So, relative velocity, if you are throwing with respect to satellite like this, this is your relative velocity. Absolute velocity will be V, and if satellite's velocity is U, the absolute velocity will be V plus U. But if V minus U, no, V plus U, relative to this is like that, then V plus U. And if it is like that relatively, then V minus U. So it depends, right? Kinetic energy depends. But if If it talks about the absolute velocity, then it doesn't depend. So I think 30% question you did not get right. Here are two subjective questions. We are starting with the simple, basic ones. Both of them. Let's do one by one. The first question, you have 3 minutes to complete. Another mass is kept over here. The force on this mass because of these two together will be
zero.
Zero. Cancel out. The only force will be because of that. So net net force will be upward. This distance is how much?
Root
3 a by 2. So distance between these two is root 3 a by 2. These two forces are anyway getting cancelled. So net net force is G M square divided by root 3 a by 2 whole square. Right? This is the answer. What about the midpoint or the center of triangle is centroid? Here it will be 0. You can see that one force is here, other force is there, this one is here. They are in equilibrium. How do you know they are in equilibrium? Q. This angle is 120. This is also 120, this is also 120. If they follow the sine rule, then they are in equilibrium. What is the sine rule? Suppose it is alpha, beta, gamma. F1, F2, F3. If F1 by sine alpha is equal to F2 by sine beta. If this is true, then they are in equilibrium. You can also check on x-axis and y-axis net force. Both will come out to be zero. Lamy's theorem. You've done it, right?
Yeah.
Vectors. Okay, this one, second one?
So root 3 gm square by 4 a square.
Yeah.
What?
So root 3 by 4 gm square by a square.
Yeah.
3 uniform sphere are kept in such a. Any other square? 2. So, I think this is also simple only. You just have to get the diagram proper. This is a diagram? Right? Chup ho jao. Distance between these two is 2r. Between these two also 2r. Since they are sphere, I can treat them like point masses located at the center. Okay? So this is one force, this is another force. You have to find the magnitude of force any one of the sphere due to the other two. So there are two forces, both are having magnitude gm square by 2 times radius square. This is F1 and this is F2 also. So two forces applied at an angle of 60 degrees, it will form an equilateral triangle or not?
Yeah.
Right? So two forces are at 60 degrees, so net force will be root over F square plus F square plus 2 F square cos 60, which is equal to root 3 F. So root 3 times, this is the answer. Done? See, if you're not getting the first one, you can try out the second one also. Someone was talking about dancing stars, right? Here you have 4 masses dancing around. How they will move? They will move due to their own mutual gravitational attraction, and it should be symmetrical motion because everyone will move in a similar way. Okay, the only option left is with respect to this axis, all of them revolve around like that. Are you getting it? So they will move in a circle of this, all these four masses. This is how they will move, and all of their velocities will be same. At every moment, they will be forming a square only. Now solve it. The answer is a little weird. 2 root 2 plus 1 divided by 4.
2 root 2 plus
1. Yeah. Under root of that into root of Gm by R.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See, the net force on this you have to find out. It will be towards the center. One force will be from this mass, one force will be due to that mass. So net force in this direction will be cancelled away. Getting it? And net force will be in that direction. So that net force is equal to mv square by r. Where r is what? You can find out r using the square. Shall I do it?
Even the third mass has to apply gravitation
force, right? Along a circle. Oh, radius is r only, which is given. What? Third mass?
Even the third mass has to attract it, right?
Yeah, it is attracting. No,
sir, the one on the other side.
Yeah, it is attracting.
Yeah, that's with their components in those.
They are attracting, no? Suppose this is 45 degrees. This is F1, this is F, this is F. So 2F cos 45. Plus F1. This is the net force, which is equal to mv square by r. Any doubt here? The force towards the center is mv square by r. Okay? F is equal to gm square by this distance. How much is this distance? This is r.
Root 2r.
This is r by root 2. So root 2r. Root 2r. Whole square. This is F. F1 is what? Gm square divided by how much is from here to here? This is root 2r, this is root 2r. This is equal to 2r. This is 2r, right? Okay. So 2r whole square. Substitute F1 here, F here, you get the value of velocity. Okay. Yeah, this question was one of its kind. Okay, sometimes they will tell you that there is an equilateral triangle. They started moving due to their own gravitational attraction. So from the centroid, they will move. The center of mass should be at rest. Because it is internal force, right? So center of mass should be at rest, and they should move. The only way possible is that they move in a circle like that, so that center of mass is at rest. Okay. So then you find out the net force toward the center, gravitational force, net gravitational force toward the center, and equate it to mv square by r, because it is a circular path.
So why can't we do that thing that, like, remember we had that question in which they all come towards the center, why won't it do that?
Because that center mass position will change.
No, it'll still be at the center.
The center mass position won't change, but the gravitational potential energy will change, no? But yes, velocity also changes, kinetic energy also changes, but then the coming to the wet. So, yes, they can come towards each other, but it is clearly written here that they are not. They have enough velocity to sustain this radius. You have to find that velocity. But if they don't have enough velocity to sustain this radius, the radius will change. Getting it? But here it is written that they have attained that velocity so that they are able to sustain that. Okay? So that is why when two black holes came close to each other, like what he was saying last class, they started dancing, because the velocity in tangential direction is attained so much so that it can move in a circle of that small radius. Okay? Any other doubt?
So can you solve it? I did the same thing.
It works.
Same thing. I'm not getting into calculations. Okay, we have so many questions. This is how you have to solve it. And the final answer I'll just write down, okay? Final answer is root over gm by r
are you just going?
This. Do this one now. Second one. It's all about calculations. The next question. So get the calculation right. There is nothing else. I go, sir, I know the concept, but I'm not making silly errors. That's the stupidest thing. In JEE Mains, you're not getting calculator. Remember that. Not getting it?
Point six five.
See how weak we are in calculations if we don't do the hand calculations usually.
So I got 0.6, I don't want to calculate after that point.
Yes, sir, I got 65 by 100. Kahan 7 by 11 tera?
I approximated a lot. 74 is approximately 77.
Anyways, so the acceleration due to gravity you have to find out. So gravitational force divided by mass. That is the acceleration due to gravity. Okay? Gravitational force is Gm, mass of moon divided by radius of moon plus height. This is the gravitational force. This is equal to m into g. So g is this. Okay? And if you want to take a risk, you can say that g is equal to g at the moon surface, which is g naught by 6 into 1 plus h by radius of moon the whole square. You can translate the same formula which we have derived for the earth, but the values might be given such that it may not come out to be g naught by 6. Okay, but if you already have a prior knowledge that acceleration due to gravity on moon surface is g naught by 6, 1/6 of the earth, okay, then you can take a risk like this. Understood? Okay, so we'll get 0.65 roughly.